Right, a very good evening to you. I hope you guys have had a fantastic day. Welcome to Chit Chat right here on Y254 TV. We're going to have a fantastic show, I promise you that. Now, if you're just hanging out with us, rather, for the first time, we're all about gossip. We tell you what's trending, what's happening in the lives of your celebrities, what have they been up to, all the trending topics about them. We're going to be covering them. We do a roundup. Now, my name is Feline. That's at Feline June on all socials. The hashtag is Chit Chat. Now, we have a post on Y254. That's our Facebook page and Twitter, as well as Instagram. Go comment below, utuambia where you're watching us from and your contribution to various stories we're going to be covering. And at the end of the show, we're going to be sending some love your way. Good. And if you're a fan of the show, you know I don't do this alone. I have the gang in studio, and as always, Kamakawa. I always start with our very own JC. No, that's not how we call her. We call her the sassy. I call her Sassy JC. What's up?
Hi. Mimi mwana gasiwa up hivyo kama kawaida. I deserve it. Oh, I'm JC Mogore before tuingize hiyo part nyingine. And you all just stay tuned. Mweke kipakatalishi na hapo kando.
So,
nili Google. Ni the right one, finally. The remotes, you put it aside.
Kipakatalishi.
Yeah. The kipakatalishi.
Are you sure? Laptop na nanduwe na ito tarakilishi.
Okay. Tarakilishi ni computer.
Yes, comp. Laptop, comp. Okay, sawa.
Yeah, sawa.
Desktop.
Iyo tutakuja na next time. Yes.
And then we have a tech head in studio.
Yo.
And he goes by the name?
My name is Ronald Royce. As usual.
Yeah.
And you know, we are here. Kuna mtu mtani ya kona nita wale watu udako. I'm like,
I'm saying, I love Shikishia gangster points. First of all, you are a hip hop artist. That's why. Fakua, I'm softy. What's your hip hop? When you are softy.
Living when you're just like a
good one.
We're not gangsters. We're just like super into other people's businesses. That's what we're all about. Yeah. So we're gonna be breaking that down. But let's do it. Actually, stories. I love the whole Kenyan. All Kenyan stories. We're representing 254.
Yeah.
So let's catch you up on what our favorites have been up to. Starting with our very own Kenyan students. Now, guess what? Mount Kenya University students earlier this week staged a protest over what they termed as tough exam questions. In a video making rounds on social media, it is said that MKU final year students walked out of an exam room since they couldn't bear how tough the exams were. We're not even kidding. We have a video. Check it out. During exam, I said this last week. Unakumkolea maziwa. Alikimbia hadi akakupewa maziwa ndo arudi afanye mtihani. So, same thing. These people, same word subgroup. Anyway, let's have questions. You know, question one, you're like, okay, I don't know this one. Question two. Unafungwa, turn over. Unaonaga ile like page 2.
Hakuna
kitu. Page 3. You're like, Buddha. What's going on? Like,
ukoshia. You see it too. Me too. Exam see it too.
True.
Were like, what do you mean? What do you mean? So kakuja katuambia kasoma hapo the head something. You nitango your letter head. I like, but it's for you. Unasema see you kwa nini tukwambia soma hizo questions.
Hizo tujafunzwa.
These are your questions.
You follow instructions. Imeandikwa pale you follow instructions.
Yeah.
So pale chini pia imeandikwa turn over. So that means kama kuna kitu unaweza
answer, turn over.
Una tu turn over. But yeah. Then again, Philip, sijui kama sendo ananga mwa Kenya mwa somangi before. And is it, my friend, CCTV meko hapa lakini bado naiba exam.
Kwenye wakichwa.
Yeah, meko tu hapa lakini kuna mwa Kenya.
Did he just admit to stealing exams? So that's why you'll have all your Nini, nizeto nini? Hizo certificates.
No, hakuna evidence.
Ukakuwa diri. Sini mwenye ame admit?
Hato ki admit Kenya na una evidence, hakuna mbali unapeleka.
So ni kusema.
Shika in action.
Lazima ukume shiku
in action. Anaweza
pewe mtihani. Lakini, you know, I agree. Okay, I don't agree with people walking out, protesting out of an exam.
Yeah.
But I kind of agree. I think the tough times, mpaka za COVID zinaingilia, mpaka everyone. The students, I think they got relaxed to the extent that they no longer studied like as usual,
yes,
like they used to before. Mm. So one expects pia exam, vile pia tumemaliziwa, maliziwa transaction cost and everything, wanafikiria pia hizi zingine, ahi tutaambiwa tuchore, ahi, mm-hmm, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I think pia ni the tough times too zenye ziko too. It's making sense in one way or the other. People have relaxed, people have so much on their minds. Let me tell you, kwanza students wako na mpaka hizi ma depression wase wamegonjeka sana,
mm-hmm,
because mtu amekuwa shule kutoka sijui lini tena, last year yote hajasoma.
Mm-hmm.
Ulikuwa umeambia uta graduate tena u graduate ukaambia tena hapana sijui kunaenda hapana, like it's too much for the people,
yes,
to bear.
True.
At some point I understand, but it's not justifiable walking out of the class, but still. But then again, it's making sense to ukiwa unaweza relate.
Mm-hmm.
Kama tulikuwa tunasoma Monday to Monday ya the whole semester na tunaletewa paper tunasema hatujui si yetu. Sisi tulishisema si yetu. And you know we never did that paper.
Eh, hey, lakini wacha nikudanganye.
Kuna hatu kufanya hiyo paper.
Kuna male wengine.
Na saizo ni statistics. Statistics 2 umeletewa hapo paper. Tunaambia mwalimu hii si yetu. Atatuambia hapana. Alafu ilikuwa imeandikwa so CCC development studies stroke engineering sijui what,
mm-hmm,
construction engineering sijui stroke, so ilikuwa a common unit imefanywa na,
yeah,
various departments na tulikuwa among them. Ni sisi wenye tunakaa sisi si werevu. Umeshika, so tunaona hapa
engineering
ya like hamku set paper ukaona mtu fix kwa watu wa edge. Sio hatu kuifanya, imagine.
But I think
imagine you never did the paper.
Nile, have you ever been in class with someone who's like super clever? Ule anapanga, yeah, number one always. Nyinyi mko hapo ma unakaribia average. Not that ati mko nyuma.
Ninda ndio bado tumefika katikati.
Sasa mnaletewa exam, not exam. Teacher kwa class anauliza kitu. Alafu anakuuliza like kitu ticha unisi saka Jesse
ajui nini unexpect mimi anajua ama ile ya kuwaku mshoyo ile ati wewe umeshafanya hiyo question alafu chopi wa class anamka anasema hiyo namba iko na shida na wewe ulishapata answer
kama unajua basi mimi nimepass
wala hizo lakini ameleta
sana ile watu ku copy exam.
Paka jina.
Umekopi yote yote kwetu mzima. Mwana.
Anairaruma.
Anakali.
Ticha, wangu nenu mkono ticha. Anava paper. Masa yungine wanashanga. Ah, kweni umisa asha malizo watakaripo kwa jina.
What?
Where
do
I even start?
But
I just so much so
long.
Yeah, not shida we copy. Not that we copied, ama we copy. I'm just saying.
I know everyone can relate.
No, but we all can relate at some point.
Yes, unajua sasa zingine unaletonga paper. Ukiangalia ni engineering, lakini questions ni za welding.
They
require knowledge. Yeah,
knowledge.
Lakini hizo kwanza hakuna kitu mbaya ka
general.
Wacha nikwambie ndugu yangu, kama huna hata terms zenye watu wanatumia huko nje, huwezi tackle question ya general question. Unajua iko haiko kwa notes zenye umekuwa ukisoma the whole time. Kitu meza tu.
Mimi naweza kumbuka. Tuko na Mr. Yetu
kwani. Unaona formula unaweza ekelea hapo juu ufollow. Unaulizwa
hadi high school Kiswahili si kwa na party ya Sheng.
Yeah.
Sasa hiyo ni kwa fasihi. Yeah. From the streets.
Kama hujui.
Kama hujui.
Kama una connection na watu wa Nairobi.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Isha, nani kwa andika Isha? Isha ma composition.
Unaweza kumbuka.
Those days ulikuwa unaambiwa that the day started well.
Yeah, blah.
Exactly. Unajua hata kama the day started well, ndio unaleta zile vitu kwa umefunzwa the vocabularies nini, unapeleka kwa bush.
And then we started the day.
Yes. Unamalizanga aje? Lakini masomo.
Very stupid.
Hapo tu 02 see me.
See me. Hadi 02. See, you go on 802, it's going to oxygen. I'm Arsenal.
school
is not
just. School is fine, though. But I understand. When you're a little, you can get around.
When the teacher looks at you in the exam room, na kuna kitu ulikuwa unafanya ndani, you're like,
that is when you pretend to be thinking.
You know, I did that over 1,000.
I know. I think we all do that.
That is when you pretend to be thinking. You're like,
hey, it's
I know. Unaona ngazi katuni. Tumanjiro ati. Nimefikirianga.
Alafu aleta kale ka light bar.
Na kuna kitu unaona.
Nothing.
There's nothing you're seeing.
Ah, lakini kuna like wengine wanataka examine na jotoi ni kunipunish. Hakuna kitu kingine nimesoma.
Mkakuwa kwanza mmepita cut.
I know nothing. Unajua kazi ni exam ya leo.
I saw another meme. So I say watoto, like I actually forgot what the correct word was, but it got fill in the blank spaces. Alafu wameacha words mbili, alafu nyuma ni vid. So mtoto watoto wanaandika COVID.
Ah, watu wasome tofauti. Hiyo ni ile. Hiyo ni what? Mic drop.
What is the COVID? You can actually remember. Unajua imekuwa tu kila saa everywhere you look. Ukienda online, ukienda WhatsApp status, TV, channel,
you're living in the middle of a pandemic, si joke was there.
Lakini ulionaka KCP venye results zilitolewa, at least some people performed.
But oh, yeah.
When you're going to summer, you're going to put a 120 in a kutoa. But anyway, mazee, so many.
Be nice.
So
but it's true.
But there's some people who is like privileged. Let me tell you something. Was it compared to Oshago and I have to cross rivers to Juna?
But my job is to talk to Kwanza and you are Ocha.
Yeah.
Imagine.
Then they work hard. Alafu na imagine mtu wa Nairobi they have a first of all wewe unatoka tu kwa nyumba basi inakukujia hapo na bodi itakurudisha kwa
imagine conditions ya na mnafanyanga the same exam at the end of the day.
Na chapwi, ushago utachapwa, utanyeshewa
kwa sababu utatoka ukifika home uende kwanza utoe uniform ufue junior kesho. Umalize kufua, uende ukatafute sijui kuni za kupika sapa na maji.
Na
ukitafuta utumwe duka, hakuna kulisha chumvi. Ukuje na uko na homework. Umemaliza, mama yako akipika uchunge watoto, muangalie watoto. Amaliza kupika, mrudi. Like it's a hassle.
Alafu you still have to wake up and be in school at 5 a.m. in the morning. Hebu niambie mtu kawe atapita aje. Na shuleni labda tena stima.
Umeenda tambali. Imagine all this yenye Jesse amesema. Ukifika hapo mazee umechoka. And then lunch time unajua nini utakula? Githeri na uji. Kwa hende class, wanze kulala, mpaka fuku.
Lakini uzirio ushago, yu githeri, mwede isunda. Apo
kwa unaifanya, mkiwa double CRE.
Mkiwa double CRE.
Mkiwa double CRE.
Na uji.
I don't know if it's a good oldies. Hashtag is chit-chat on Facebook. We want to know your experience. Mazi easy exams. We've all been there. Tell us your experience. We'd love to read all about it. At the end of the show, we're going to be sampling some of those comments. Now, we go over to another story. Now, a Kenyan content creator, Adi Gogo, has shaved his dreadlocks in honor of George Floyd after the court found his killer guilty. In his video, Adi Gogo explained that having been a victim of police brutality at one point and finally seeing Floyd's family get justice was a call for celebration, and to celebrate him, he decided to cut off his long locks. Social media users were over the moon knowing that former Minneapolis police officer Derek Chauvin has been found guilty on 2 counts of murder and manslaughter. Let's have a look at the video.
The most important story, George, rest in peace. Now, I'm poor son of police for justice. I'm say my being a victim, police, any police force, affect to me an excessive force. I'm going to do my own push around. I'm going to say my own life matters. Eh? So justice, George, Ms. Chiapua Sana. Now, the most important thing I can do, push around. Yes, at least nothing relieved. The most is a fan.
Yay! Amen. So leader, you see, like, dude just did something so commendable.
No,
imagine, imagine they go bald for someone just like that. Putting someone first, I'm not feeling that from the bottom of my heart. It should come with, from within. Na fa kui feel yani because he has that say. Any story, many touch. To just honor, I'm gonna pay some homage. Mimi nitanyonyelea. Inafaa kutoka with them. And this is a Kenyan man.
Alikuwa na mpango wa kunywa hizo dredi.
Feeling.
Na nimewaambia hivyo alikuwa na mpango wa kunywa dredi.
Unaweza kukumbuka kweli wa mwere?
Na,
in 2002. Alinyoa dredi je? You remember alisema tukitoa tu moyo kwa power na nyoa dredi. And that is what he did.
And he actually did that.
Acha niwaambie kitu. Mtu anakuanga na mpango wa kunyoa. Lakini lazima nitafute reason legit. Do you know dredi inakuanga imefika mahali mmekuwa na bond nayo. Unajua most people who are lock, have locks wanakuanga wamebond na nywele yao. Like you can't even touch their hair. So yeah imefika point pia sasa imefika ile point inafikanga wanataka kunyoa and then you have a fresh start. Ikakuwa tu kuna kitu imehappen. Akona let me ride with this wave.
No, but I'm actually tempted to side with her. I remember there's a while back, there's a model, her name is Jean. I posting, you know, wedding gown. Now we tried to go back to Molewa. Shock, no, there was no wedding. It was not.
Kenya is like, what you are.
So I feel like,
do not underestimate us.
Possibility, maybe.
Yes,
she might be right.
Very possible.
But we don't know. We don't stand up with each other. But then, like, on a serious note, because this story of George Floyd is not even something, like a small. This guy was murdered. Like, there was a video. We saw this.
Live.
This person could not breathe. And he kept telling them, I can't breathe. No, I'm saying bad or two. 8 straight minutes. Do you know 8 minutes?
In fact, it was 9 minutes.
9 minutes, yes, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 9 minutes. Imagine. You took someone's life. I love, do you know? He, I was following his story a while back before he was actually convicted. Alikuwa anasema ati his lawyers, they were alleging that ati Floyd was sick. He was actually just meant to die on that day. It was
Said he had some this
he had a condition.
This dawa that is given to people. It's a painkiller. It's not oftenly prescribed to everyone. And then you're given it. Sijui mamshe yona watu wanatokanga husi. It's like amewekwa patch ya kitu. And mekelewa ni kama alikuwa mkatwa. Inakatango kadogo, iningie kwa bloodstream pole pole.
Yeah.
Especially even for people who have endo, wanapewangwa. Hiyo dawa. But iki overprescribiwa, ineza kuwa addictive, na ineza kuwa like a drug. It makes you feel like you're kind of high and all. That is what they were saying alikuwa nayo. Truth to it, he had it. But that was not the reason alikufa. Reason ya Floyd kukufa, alipostmortem ilionyeshana ni strangulation. Nio, kufinywa ni.
We saw that.
Witness, uliona mama White, ali witness, akasema, I begged him to stop doing that.
Yeah.
I begged him.
Daddy, even the guys on duty.
Yes.
One of the police officers stepped forward to come tap him.
What are you doing, man? I love you. The fact that alikuwa nakaa ni kama hata anafurahia what he was doing. You know, it's like he was. Kwani?
He's not back in pocket.
Don't get him wakati umenil.
I know.
Aki filinu unaweza fikiria ku pocket kama umenil.
I don't think I'll do that
confidence.
Confidence.
Let me tell you something. Can you even think about this? Like, what's happening in the US is so sad.
Yeah.
And our brothers and sisters that are there, like, we just have to. As much as, like, things are bad, but you don't experience such kind of racism. Unaget?
Yes.
Because we saw story, there's an army officer.
Yes, I saw.
Did you guys see?
Yes.
I'm saying, like, he's an army officer. Ameva uniform. Anabeba mikono hivi anatoka kwa gari kama raia. Saizo mempointia gari. So disrespectful.
It's,
I hope these people.
It's because he's an African American again.
Yeah, joko mzungu.
Yeah, kukua mzungu.
Atoke hivi. Na kona uniform. Si ati anawambia, ati anosho ID, ati by the way, I'm in there. No, he's in full uniform.
Umayo na mzungu, anyway, amekuwa appointed a gunner in the US.
Do you know, let me tell you something weird. The Minneapolis, like where this whole incident happened, it is this cop is the first person to be convicted of murder ever in history of Minneapolis. He is the first person, the first white person. There was an incident, Kitambo, in the 90s, but that was a black, black man.
Yes.
Now, this is the first white person to ever face conviction of a murder.
He's even lucky.
So many murders.
He's lucky. I saw some tweets, the people in the US saying that he's just lucky he's in Minneapolis.
Yeah.
While ngemtaka aende kama Indiana, Louisiana. Unaona huko kwenye kuna black cells.
Yeah.
Aliambiwa kuna bahati ameenda kwa cell yenye haina blacks.
Yeah.
Na ameua black person. He's just even lucky. He should even be thanking God. Okay, I saw other people, watu unajua kuna kuona watu wenye wana think, ako like, okay, yes, he killed him, but then family yake akiwa amemlilia haku fikiria Floyd akona mtoto dem. Huyo mtoto wa Floyd saizi baba anitaka
nani baba? Nani baba? Like people,
okay,
you know, stuff,
justice,
like,
justice should be
served. You kill someone literally.
Being begged by the other people.
Yeah.
Ngoja ni waulize, by the way, na huyo askari mwingine alikuanga anazunguka hapo nikaa nafanya.
There were two of them.
Eh, huyo alifungwa nini?
There was one who was white.
Asian alifutangwa job.
Kitambo.
Yeah.
Kitambo. Yeah, I remember he alifutangwa job
hata before conviction. Police brutality, I think, in Minneapolis will also come from the name. Mine?
What does that mean?
Police.
Eh?
CEO Jim.
I'm answer word play.
I know, so I didn't know.
What I mean, you're like
Minneapolis. Minneapolis. So they will always use the last name.
Police.
Yes.
Oh, so it's you like. Oh,
yes, they are now, it's being ruined by police. But anyway, justice was served at least.
Lakini huyu wetu ni kiki, hiyo mimi sinasahau.
Back home.
Maze bocha enda, maze mchenza kwa wewe.
At least he had the guts to stand up and say, like, kuna joni story ya majuna wa Kenya wanaingilia nga watu, ukipost mtu.
Tona vile na kuangalia na
liki. So I'm like, you know what? At least he had the guts to
post about it.
Yani, ipo in his brutality na fanyika hapa Kenya uoni, unenda kupost mtu wata uoni. Kids are always like that. So, shout out to you,
yeah,
man. Like, it takes guts to do something like that.
I know.
So,
like,
but,
ni
yeah.
Kiki tu.
I love kidogo kidogo ojiwa naanza kumwingilia ma celebrity niliona naanza kumchonga kina yani shiti oji.
Hata mimi niko hiyo nini ya
kidogo. Kinyo unakanga different.
Alafu najua most dedicated kwa Kiara inaanza hapa katika tajiri.
No, but I'm not Kiara. That was a good course, though. So we're going to move into another story. Now, businessman Jamal Rohosashi revealed that he had a dark past. Wow. Before he met his now second wife, socialite Amber Ray. Now, speaking to Jalangon, Jamal said that Amber was his saving grace, and he is so happy and glad that he met her. Jamal was clearing the air after his first wife denied claims that Amber was legally married to him. His father rubbished claims that Amber uses charms to keep him, saying that he loves Amber so much that she even manages his social media pages. So, if you actually have a video for that, let's just have a look at the video then come back.
Jala Salim sanitize.
Nikapatia the funniest thing.
Nikapatia
paka the funniest thing. Nikapatia paka account zangu zote za Instagram za nini kila kitu the funniest thing. Nikampatia paka the funniest thing. Nikampatia paka account zangu zote za Instagram za nini kila kitu ndo na manage.
Yeye ndiye ana run.
Eh, kutakujua yani nilisha change lifestyle yangu sasa.
So madem wenye uingia kwa DM yako,
hata yeye juzi ukiandika message ukareplywa na yeye.
Eh. Nikikwambia kuja interview.
Ai, yeye ndo alireply immediately because niliacha life. Na once chalia sha make decision anaona enye life ya. Unajua kuna ile
sasa madem mnaonwa by the way.
Ni sawa. Funniest thing. Nikampatia paka account zangu zote za Instagram za nini kila kitu ndo na manage.
Yeye ndiye ana run.
Eh, kutakujua yani nilisha change lifestyle yangu.
So, Ladies, you need Amber Ray. I think Amber Ray should start like a fan club or something. Apparently, tips on how to get people to do that. I mean, mtu anapatia social media pages na passwords is like talk to them. Uliskadia kusema hadi Jalango bila alikuwa yo what's up? Can you come around? Can you have an interview and stuff?
It's her who replied.
Amber is the one who replied.
Yes.
Hey, Jesse, what are we doing wrong? Do you want to put a password? You're like. mostly women, like, unajua kila mtu akaina simu yake, don't touch my phone, don't touch your phone. Ini like, oh, you can't just touch my phone. You can touch my phone and even have the password to social media.
So,
zile mki slide kwa DMs, you're like, oh, hi. Kwanza alisema mademu wana sliding. There's a hi, handsome. She's like,
I have.
What's up? It's me you're talking to. Yes.
Sasa, mimi napenda ambari sana.
Yeah.
Kwa hivyo hapa niko na shida, sijui nitasema nini. Juu, ambari, at one point, I just feel she's self-made.
Yeah.
And people will always pull you down.
Mm-hmm.
Alifikisha 1 million subscribers on IG.
And people don't even know what she does. People
nah.
Like,
mpaka yeye akasema na mimi hadi msanii mzee. Like, sie tunaimbanga, mimi si nini. Na nimefikisha 1 million followers.
I know.
You know? Mm-hmm. And I think she's just lucky.
Yeah.
Do you know there are people who are just born lucky?
Aye.
Yeah. There are people who are born lucky. Ambare kila kitu anafanyanga yake inaendanga kiprosper.
Alright, but can we talk about the fact that in an interview some people found it sort of like an offense somehow, the fact that Jamal disrespected his first wife.
Yeah, definitely.
What do you have to say about that?
That is why he may support Amber. Because me, he said, yeah, Amber, coming to this guy, he disrespects the wife.
Yeah.
Automatically, he does. Nakumbuka hata kwa hiyo live nilikuwa, watu walikuwa nasema, we toka hapa, enda. Like, that is what people, comments zilikuwa za hiyo. Hata ukienda sa hizi YouTube wangali hiyo, ni ya jealous.
Yeah.
Alikuwa naambiwa, toka, enda, nini, huyu ni nani, nini hii, anasema nini, and kwanza mostly ni meno, alikuwa nasema hivyo.
Yeah.
Ni nini unatuambia? What can you tell
people
us?
Are, like, people feel like, the moment you have like a side chick or another woman, you have to
respect your first wife.
Your wife.
Yes, your wife has to come first.
Yeah, but this guy is all about Amber now. Like, he's like, Amber.
Wacha bambike. Amber pia ni mrembo. Juu pia mimi nikiwa msichana na ninaona ni mrembo. Na imagine ya kiwa mwanaume chenye anaona sasa. Unashika?
Yeah, and then they've been friends for a very long time.
Yeah,
before.
But do you know Amber and Nani were friends and the wife? You saw that story.
No, kisema tina,
they were friends.
Walikuwa neighbors. So wakaenda wakamwambia, oh, nataka kujiona tena kwa kanga lashes. Ilianza na lashes. Oh, nini. Ati alafu, not knowing she's the one who will come and destroy my marriage.
But then, you see,
but this is what I will tell people. Mm-hmm. Once a cheat, always a cheat.
Yeah.
Once a cheat, always a cheat.
It doesn't matter how
na
you
hiyo ni those. Bottom line.
Yeah.
Na hiyo hata nyinyi wenye mko hapo bado hamjolewa, muangalie huyo boyfriend ulijaribu kusamehea mara ya kwanza. Tuunipate inbox uniambie ulimsamehea mara ngapi zingine. Once a cheat, always a cheat. Hiyo ndio bibi yake anafaa jua.
Ana niambia watu wengi reform.
Watu wengine wanaweza reform.
Wagani? Wana reform mingi jeu uzee. Wagani? Ni wale wa babas wanakuanga hivi kwa club 5 AM na taska.
Bado wacha niko big tu moja.
Umewajua? Wa babas. Katikati ya vijana wadogo. Mkisema wa mlambe. Eh, wa mnyonye.
Oh, that was
buying
zoom and
over.
Yeah.
Unajua, men from the lakeside, kama kuna watu respect their wives, men from the lakeside.
Hmm?
Right. Yes, hata kama atakuwa na side chick, remember, you will always remind the side chick.
Your position.
Yes, you know that I still have someone in the house.
Mm-hmm.
Sasa wewe tu itakuwa tu ni ya, unataka kuenda Dubai.
Wani sherehe.
Exactly. Tuende IG, nini, you go and post everything. But there's someone always.
Yeah. But then they say men never leave their wives. But then Jamal is Muslim, and Muslims are allowed to marry up to 4 wives.
Yes.
So there's a difference.
So he could have just added Amber to the number.
No, that's what he did. Not could have. He
alisema wameoana.
Amesema like,
lakini we are here for the tea.
Mm-hmm.
Mimi siwaombei mabaya. Mimi nataka tawakuwe happy. Lakini we are here for the tea anyway. Tusi tungoje the next time tunai discuss this story. Juni naiona tukiongelelea. The once Kenyans wameingilia issue ya watu, inakuanga vitu zinaanza kuenda hivi.
Yeah.
Sijui mbona sisi tunakuanga hivyo. Once Kenyans wameanza kukua a lot about...
But that's the reason why they prospered. Do you remember his story? Like Chimasta, Edgar, shout out to Edgar. You ilianza upale kwa Edgar Obare, walikuwa na ficha. Watu wakaanza kusend receipts kila siku wa mawawana.
Mukono. Mukono. Na wakanya. Isa.
Wanachapa
kasa. Nela Isa.
Isa ndio hii. Mukono inapia kwa live ya Amber. Mtu waka screenshot. Wow, Kenyans.
Maybe they had to go in there like, okay, fine. We are dating, okay?
Watu wadaku wa Kenyans ndio MVPs. How was it? TMZ kanda.
I know.
TMZ hakuna wajua. By the way, unajua tea yetu inakuanga na sukari.
Yeah, tungu.
We're gonna move on to the next one. Now, up and coming social media sensation Manzi wa Kibera has dragged singer Bahati for his choice of hairstyle in a video posted on her Instagram. The lady called out Bahati for choosing to braid his hair, telling him to stay on his lane that he is neither diamond or Ray Valley. We have a video.
If you are a man of God, Bahati, umeshuka nini zoza wa mama? Baha, you are not diamond. Respect yourself, you are a man of God. Respect the church, respect the industry, the gospel industry. Reivani na Eric Omondi. Andi watu wenye tunatambua na hizo mastyle. Respect church, respect you are a man of God. Sawa, ukienda pale kwa hao, set standard straight kwa watu. Iwa jwe baba ndio huyu, mama ndio huyu. Si leo, wakiamka asubuhi wanakupata umeva skirt, umepiga makeup, umepiga mpaka wigs juu ya blonde, unaona. Hata maybe ndani ulikuwa na thong. Bahati nimekupea 2 days. You come out clean. Na useme wewe ni secular artist. Yes, kuna kwa na wewe na motu ameka chini mnaongea. Sijui embarambara ache kuruka ruka. Ona venye unaamka asubuhi. Umepiga Bahati. Umeshuka nini zoza wa mama? Baha, you are not diamond. Respect yourself, you are a man of God.
But to be honest, no shade. It's clearly like evening, there's no sun, so no shade. But with them number high, there's a difference. Kudu, you know, like it's a case of a pot calling sufuria.
Ile, unaona ile saying it's really kwangi polite. Ile nyani haonangi nini yake. Le, nyani haoni le. Nyani haoni le. Nojo bado 7 haijafika. Nyani haoni nini le. Ni hiyo. This is that. Na hii ni kiki. Aki Kenyans. Aki si. Aki mnanibambanga creativity yenu na kuongo on point. Mnangoja Bahati tu ashuke vitu za white. Yeye ana prosper. Ngoma zake zinafikisha views. Sijui ngapi huko akilipangwa na YouTube. Na wewe uko tu hapo umeenda nika waste. Nikakwambia hapa nishike hii video. Na uinue hii video. Inua juu. Ni anishike.
No,
She's too busy from the way she's talking.
She's her colors.
She's shouting everywhere. Mm-hmm. Shouting for the colors.
It's gray.
Yes,
gray. Nini kwa padi wave. Na huku nyuma.
Sinasema aliuliza before film. Nini itafanya waongee.
Ni nest. Alikuwa ameweka nest huku akaamua. Ni kiki mazi.
But she's pretty though.
Ah no, tunasema kukua mrembo ni mrembo. But ako busy. Ako na sunglasses. Alifanya intentionally. Wacheni niwaambie. One thing, kama tumekuwa kwa industry so tumejua. Ameifanya intentionally. Akaona nichukue Baha na yeye papa sasa. Ndiyo mkiongea pia mnasema hata yeye alikuwa anafanya nini. Wacha niende ni muone. Ni vizuri hata nimemjua leo.
No, but I'm really proud of her though. Do you know why I'm proud of her? Because when first she came, she was like that ratchet. She doesn't care. And then when she took very, how do you say this? the photos, very private photos like on social media and stuff. Alifanya photo shoots zingine, you. And then when the man spoke out about them, she apologized actually. She was like, I'm so sorry, especially to my mom, because that's not how she raised me. You get? At least she recognized what she was doing was wrong. And then she was like, yo, sorry.
I hope she also recognizes what she's doing is wrong also. Come on, into one, recognize wrongdoings. Exactly, at a year.
Yeah, but Ron, what do you think of Bahar's hairstyle though, as an artist? What do you think of his hair? Sorry about that. It happens live on live shows. Yes. So I'm asking like, you have to like me. What's that?
Okay. Nah. Manager, as an artist.
Yeah.
Okay. It's cool.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
That's cool.
But then I am tangu kamsi wa gospel bado.
Kwani ni wapi gospel iliambiwa wasi nini?
Wasishuke.
Si tuliambiwa Yesu alikuwa na nywele imefika huko nyuma. Nini inakuanga shida ya watu? Nini inakuwa nini mbaya ya watu?
I don't know, but unajua?
Samson sinia alikuwa na ile nywele refu kabisa.
Na kanyoa spinal
nywele. Na nina vile hiyo ilikuwa vitu ilikuwa strength yake.
Ile ile nywele.
Unajua tabaha strength yake ni nywele yake. Anapakanga pink mnaongea. Akashuka braids mkaongea.
Sasa ameshuka uzi. Baadaye anatoa album.
Na mnaongea tu yake. Yeye anaendelea tu kubrini. Bro, keep doing you, man. Do you.
Be you.
Do you.
Do you.
Do you. Hata mazila kibera do you. Hiyo kiki mekufanya nikakujua do you.
Yeah, lakini mazote ana shout from the colors.
Lakini I choose black dress next time. Akishoot, ambiwe lighting, kuna vile inatakanga kereazi.
Lakini sisi ni ambiwanga tia kia kwa hila share kwa mandiete atalikuanga na nguo moja. So let her prosper. Kayo ndo anaeza.
Pengine na
wana. It's true. Not my words.
Bada ni makumbuka ni ambiwangu wa hivyo.
Lakini. Wendo wana mbunu unatuangusha. Watu wanakuja.
Pengine na wana
mwenye na represent Kenya. You're like, what's happening? What's happening?
Wanda Eriko maybe akumchoose kama wife.
Now, thousands of motorists and passengers were stuck in traffic for hours after police blocked major roads in Nairobi last Saturday to enforce the curfew regulations. The main road in Yelguan is thicker road. Yani, Adi, even Diana, we're speaking about Bahati, but now the wife, Alipapale, thicker road. And this is happening for what she had to say.
Blocked the roads now, Amesama. Hey guys, what's up? So right about now, niko Thika Road, and the situation right now is that curfew time imefika, so they've blocked the roads. Now amesema, you know what? Tunalala kwa barabara hadi 4 a.m. So this is the situation. You can see. Kama mnaona. So they've blocked the road all the way. Hiyo yote ni traffic. So that's the situation. Barabara zimefungwa kutoka huko juu. Hakuna gari zinaenda, hakuna gari zinarudi. Kuna ambulance pale, kuna mgonjwa. So huyo mgonjwa pia anafaa kaa hapo. As you can see guys, this is just before Mountain Mall. Mountain Mall iko kule mbele. Don't know if you can see it. Oh Lord. So that is my...
Then hizi magari unaona ziko mbele zote wamechukua kiss, so there is no way at his neza zikapass.
Wait. Hey. But then Sato, unajua sasa Sato kuna vile ungepita ati mimi wa media it's blocked everywhere. Fly basi. Ati mimi essential worker where okay, you want to pass, go.
Kama.
Do you know walisema hizo gari zilibebwa? At some point my
colleagues zilichukuliwa huko ndio video. Ndio ziondolewa kwa barabara ndio watu wapite.
They carried the gari walikuwa na kii.
Tumeziweka kando. Tumeweka hapo kando. Ati wapi? Wanaume waliinua gari.
bado mko na ngumu. Mnabeba gari.
Unaweza kumbuka now the second day what happened was makarausi walikuwa wamekeza mneni juu. Yeah. Everybody was in a rush.
Yeah.
Kuna msee wa hizi lorries. Alikuja kaigonga.
Yeah, but that was a bad accident.
Juu hata the people were hurt. Yeah. Askari was hurt.
But then kitu kilimbamba on Sunday. Karamu wakasema, you know what? Tutawajenga leo sika jana. Unafanya nini? Bonfire. Polekea baba akasema, "Mna complain baridi." Kujeni hapa. So guys were like, kama ulikuwa umetoka maeneo
uko na Kenya.
Kenya, my country people.
Aise rudi rivers
sura jiwa na zima mambia mimi nimefika basi
azime juu nini destination ijafika
ma unaona zima it doesn't make sense how did I forget anyway
but lala lala paka 4 a.m.
That is so wrong.
That is so wrong. But I'm taking advantage of the situation. But
I think it's high time to learn to catch up na the 8 p.m. curfew.
Right,
yeah. To manage your 7 p.m.
yeah.
Tukamanage ya 9, mnakumbuka tulienda hivyo ndio tukawekewa hadi 11. To manage ndio hata tutoleweni. Kama tunataka tutolewo hapa, this is beyond us, wasee. It is beyond us. There are some things that are beyond us right now. If we are not adhering to them, at this time we are the masses of the government.
Yeah.
So it's either we do their thing ama sisi tuishi hivyo.
We just suffer.
It's as easy as that. Kama vile sisi tumeadapt kukujanga show 6.
Yeah. Exactly.
It's not even any funny. Yeah, but we have to.
Honestly, show you kwanga 7. No,
yeah,
no.
We have to.
We adopt.
Yeah, we adapt pole pole. And when time it arudi normal, we'll do our thing back normally.
In fact, it's the new normal.
We are hoping vitu zitarudi sawa as soon as possible.
I know.
Because
I know.
It's so, not working for anyone. Jota ya wasewa usiku wenye wanafanya. Unajua, someone was saying, in Kenya, economy we ina run from 5. Watu wa maofisi wa kitoka. Up to 9. Na unajua ni kweli?
Yes, ni kweli.
Wasee ndio wanaingianga shops. Beshti yangu anatengenezanga nails.
Yeah.
Alikuwa ananiambia hakuna nails zinatengenezwa kama usiku.
Yeah,
it makes sense.
What and it's very unfortunate. What your business wanafunga because I have a friend who died anizanguza my day. Anasema kuna events, hakuna baby shower,
nothing.
There's nothing happening.
Hakuna activity,
hakuna weather. So where are you buying and
what we do, we adhere to what the government is telling us to do. Ndio saji ende chini. Ikiisha na watu waende wadungwe vaccine. Watu wajue kwanza watu umedungwa vaccine, unakuwa prevented. The first jab inakuprevent 60%.
Yeah.
Watu wanafaa wajue hivyo. Watu sijui mbona wanaona. Ni nani mmeona ametan kukua zumbi?
Jio
ndio mnasema. Nani amekuwa zumbi akuje hapa tuambie. Yeah, tutamhost next show. Huyo zumbi akuje hapa. Watu waende wadungwe. Akiwa cage pale tu. Tumwambie. Wewe tuambie kweli juu si nini ulidungwa. Si ndio wasee wafanye hizi vitu.
That's the time we have. So can you just send like maybe a shout out then we have to go. The best is she going to
coffee. Watu wa
Mutura unajua. Like it's an essential.
Anateta watu wa Mutura.
I'll go by the name Ronald to the race and as usual
no say that again
you didn't catch it the first time.
What is that?
Okay. What's up people, I go by the name Ronald to the race and actually you know Jua Kafu. I'll always send some shout out to my buddies.
Oh,
Victor Riambo, wherever you are, Machange, you hey. Know John Bid,
Filina Kwapa,
Jesse,
Jesse Kwapa,
Jesse
Young.
To me, let's screenshot.
Masiketa, you know.
Oh, Masiketa. Shout out to all of them. Jesse.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Kama kawaida, everyone. Thank you so much for tuning in. And we are grateful. I'm Jesse Mugura, Facebook. Jacinta Mugura, Instagram. And Mugura Muresho, Twitter. Oh, wait. My deputy principal, imagine Ali to watch last Thursday.
Oh.
Such a privilege, y'all. I'm so humble.
What's his name?
Her name.
She, yes.
She was Miss Rose. Yeah. Nimtoto wake alinitext Instagram akaniambia
mama anakuangalia
and then someone else, there's someone called Dave. anakuanga silent follower. Ah. Anatuwachingi. Thank you so much. There's Caleb. Aki gay, tunawachua mpaka Germany wasi. Wache nini wa show.
Okay. Since we wale watu. Did you do that stream? Watch me on the co.tv.
Yes.
That's been fun. Let's send like, some salams to our social media people. Then we bounce, right? Alice Abio Nyongo. Anasema feeling live from Siaya. Wasi warona napa. Oh. Big shout out to you. Nadim Ametogadi Pichake. A big shout out to you. Vin King Kingston is watching live from Kisii. Shout out to Kisii. Wasi wakina embara mbamba. Eh, say. Kisii is Shout out to you guys watching live. Lighter Issa, big shout out to you. Bunny's Nduati tuned. Dennis Miner, Dennis Bob Miner. Mse wetu wako, Deno mse. Deno is actually tuned in. Nasema, here's my syndicate udaku vibe. At here at Issa Scam, hapa tumepigwa kiki international. This guy just formalized a relationship on social media. They can now be seen comfortably. Amba wamecheza kama wao. Why does Bahati hater want to cry? Is she jealous?
Wow.
Atifilini, atikafime baki wana wana badu uko tao. Jesu ongea tu. Ron, sema kime umana. Atumasa akafime fikana badu mko ugu, eh? Sema ni kime umana.
Kime umana.
One last one goes to Palma Wavasho. Rasmani, tani interview mazene to Palma Wavasho. From Naivasho, shout out to you. Send us a link if you have a song or something. We're going to be... We can host you.
Tell her to text me. I'll be going to Vasha to turn link up now.
Yeah, yes. Do that. DM Jessie. DM
Jessie.
We're going to Vasha very soon. It's been so much fun, guys. Be sure to Mose right here. Shout out to Edna. Shout out to Timo. Shout out to Hillary.
Yeah.
Shout out to Rose as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I think those
are the
guys. Yeah. Yeah, or say Hillary.
Oh,
yeah, sure. It's a village. This is so much fun, guys. We'll see you again next week with another amazing show. You're like the real MVP.
Sana.
Sana.
Bye, 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 bye.
Bye. Have a good night. Get home safe before coffee. Get it?